Welcome back, my fellow assassins, to another WWE 2K16 Universe Mode episode. We are here with SmackDown, and it is the final WWE 2K16 Universe Mode episode. As next episode on Raw, we are moving to WWE 2K17, and we are halfway to Battleground, and what a show is looking out to be. Of course, we have Cody Rhodes versus Daniel Bryan set up. We have and Shawn Michaels versus John Cena. So much more coming your way for the next few weeks. It's going to be a good show. But right now we have Cesaro, our European champion, out in the ring, and it looks like he's going to grab a mic and talk to us for a second. Let's see what he has to say. Oh, well, Cesaro putting out an open challenge for that European Championship, and Dolph Ziggler is answering the call. Dolph Ziggler. I don't know if I like Dolph Ziggler's chances here tonight. Cesaro has been in an absolute roll ever since, even before he won the European Championship, but especially when he won that championship. He's been unstoppable. Of course, winning the title at Money in the Bank in a triple threat match between Sheamus, Bad News Barrett, and himself, and then successfully defended that title against Sheamus last week. So now he says he needs more challenges. He likes the thrill. He likes the adrenaline of, even the possibility of that championship losing. Gets his blood pumping. And he wants more of that, so he's issuing out an open challenge. And right now, Dolph Ziggler and Cesaro for the European Championship to start off SmackDown, the final SmackDown episode of WWE 2K16. Thank you guys for joining me here tonight. It's been a long ride for WWE 2K16, but we're moving on. WWE 2K17 is coming your way soon for Monday Night Raw. But right now, let's get to this European Championship open challenge. And Cesaro now has a Boston Crab, but Dolph Ziggler using that leg strength against Cesaro. But Cesaro, I mean, personally, I don't know about you guys, but personally, I like Cesaro's chances here tonight. Dolph Ziggler has not been too fond of his chances or too fond of his matches lately. He has not won a match in such a long time. But Cesaro has won every match he's been in pretty much in the last 2 months. So polar opposites in this match here tonight, but the funny thing about our Universe Mode, you can never bet on it. And the reason why is because you have to expect the unexpected. You never know what's going to happen here in our Universe Mode. Stranger things have happened. I keep going back to, of course, Titus O'Neil winning the Royal Rumble. That has to be example numero uno, but nevertheless, it holds true as anything could happen here in our Universe Mode. And tonight, Dolph Ziggler could walk away as your European champion. But enough of me rambling. Let's get back to this match. Cesaro, now just hammering away and just takes Ziggler down. And Cesaro has a new lease on his career. Ever since winning that European Championship, his very first singles title, very first title in WWE Universe Mode. And you can tell he's on the top of his game. Ever since winning that championship, even before they're winning that championship. So it's going to be hard for Ziggler or anyone else to take away that title. Nope.
Oh!
Back suplex there by Dolph Ziggler. And, I mean, Cesaro, a fan favorite from all these fans here in the SmackDown Arena. And those of you watching at home, you guys wanted Cesaro to be champion. I wanted Cesaro to be champion because Cesaro's a fucking monster in that ring. But nevertheless, Cesaro is your European champion and hopefully one that can stay for a long time. Because Cesaro is a talent that we want to keep here on SmackDown. And you know, sooner or later, the rosters are going to be switched up a little bit. It's inevitable. But hopefully we keep Cesaro on SmackDown as a Northern Lights suplex by Dolph Ziggler. And speaking of trades and switching brands, I think Dolph Ziggler could be one to maybe go over to Raw and try to get a little fresh start here in Yard Universe mode, because he cannot buy a win on SmackDown for his life. I mean, battling the likes of Daniel Bryan and now Cesaro, and just could not get a win. Look at this German suplex by Dolph Ziggler. So let's get back to this match. German suplex. Dolph Ziggler looking good right now with the DDT. And Dolph Ziggler could be your European champion walking out today. Oh! Now the shoulder barge, but Cesaro not going to let that happen that quickly. Now Cesaro has got Dolph Ziggler. No! Dolph Ziggler with a kick right to the back of the knee. No! Oh! Cesaro answers right back. And a German suplex of his own. Move for move here. Now Cesaro go over the pin. 1-2. And no! Cesaro trying to finish this match early. I mean, oh, he just went through two tough battles in two consecutive weeks, two consecutive episodes with Sheamus. Oh, as he won the title at Money in the Bank, then defended the title the week afterwards on SmackDown, and now oh, going at the legs of Dolph Ziggler. And you gotta think if the European Joe. Wait a minute, Swiss Death. European uppercut, and let's see if that finishes off Dolph Ziggler. Two! No. Dolph Ziggler kicking out two. Like I was saying, if Cesaro puts on that championship every week on SmackDown, what an opportunity everyone has here on the SmackDown roster to get a championship. If Cesaro, well, if Stone Cold allows it anyway, if he can defend that title each week, you're not even... Not only will we have fantastic matches between Cesaro and said opponent each week, because Cesaro can bring out the best in anyone here in our SmackDown roster. Not only that, but it brings up the prestige of the European Championship. So that's exciting. And now Dolph Ziggler. Oh! Now with a neckbreaker onto Cesaro. Now Cesaro getting up to his feet. Oh, and a European uppercut. And now it's a snapmare by Dolph Ziggler. Going to try to slow the pace down. Dolph Ziggler is one to use those wrestling holds, use those amateur wrestling tactics against Cesaro, but Cesaro is just too powerful. Oh, another European uppercut! And could that be it? But Cesaro cannot get to the pin. Dolph Ziggler now has a moment to capture himself and try to regain a breath, and now he's going to try to get back to his feet. Cesaro put everything he had into that European uppercut, but it was to no avail. Is oh, you cannot get to the cover now. Knee, and now look at this. Dolph Ziggler going to go for a neck breaker. Oh, and he plants him down right into the mat. And oh, Dolph Ziggler all going to go for these 10 consecutive elbows as he calls the heart stopper. Going for 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And there's the show off Dolph Ziggler for number 10. And now gonna go for a pin. I don't think that'll put away Cesaro just yet, but no, it doesn't. Cesaro still in this matchup, still the champion for right now. But will he be the champion when that bell rings? We'll see. Oh, zigzag by Dolph Ziggler. Could this be it? Is Cesaro even in this match? Is he knocked out? Will Cesaro lose his championship right now? No! Cesaro pulling out all the stops. I mean, sorry, Dolph Ziggler putting out all the stops. But Cesaro gets his shoulder up, powering out of it. Maybe just out of instinct. But now Dolph Ziggler trying to figure out what to do. He's going to go for another neck breaker. Yes, he is. And now Ziggler. Now looking for an Irish whip, but Cesaro. Oh, now an elbow by Ziggler. Ziggler looking good in this match. Oh, wait a minute. Just like what I said, out of nowhere, the neutralizer. The neutralizer by Cesaro. Now go over cover. One, two, three. And still, your European champion is Cesaro. What a match. Let's look back. This is the zigzag by Dolph Ziggler. Which almost, we almost had a new champion. We almost had a new champion. There's the cover. One, two, but Cesaro, just by instinct alone, heard the two and just kicked out. But look at this. Look at the impact of this neutralizer. Picks him up. And then, bam! Right on the face and the chest. And that would be it for Dolph Ziggler. There's the three count. And still, your European champion, Cesaro. Cesaro putting on a hell of a match here tonight. And that's the championship right there. And I can safely assume that the European Open Challenge will be open. Well, of course it'll be open next week. But guys, the main event is Christian going against Cody Rhodes. Cody Rhodes returns to action here tonight in our main event. But guys, let's get to some action here. More one-on-one action as Tyson Kidd comes down to the ring. And if you guys notice, the title of this episode is Implosion is because of this. Last week on SmackDown, Tyson Kidd would actually attack his partner, Sami Zayn, with his spinning fisherman suplex neckbreaker type thing after Tyson Kidd lost the match and just the frustration took over and he attacked his tag team partner. That's what led to this match here tonight. Tyson Kidd versus Sami Zayn. Sami Zayn, of course. And I think this all stemmed from Sami Zayn qualifying for the Money in the Bank ladder match and Tyson Kidd not qualifying. Of course, Sami Zayn would defeat Sheamus and then Tyson Kidd would lose to Tyler Breeze. And I think that's what stemmed from it. And it just grew and grew over time. And Tyson Kidd just along with, you know, it has the same story as Dolph Ziggler. Tyson Kidd could not get a win to save his life. And then, you know, you see the Sami Zayn getting more and more successful as his career goes on. And, you know, you just take it, you take your frustrations out on him. So now we lead to this match. Two former tag team partners battling out here tonight. So let's get Tyson Kidd versus Sami Zayn. So here we go. The bell rings. Here we go. And, you know, this match is going to be off the chain, you know that, but it's such an emotional roller coaster as well. As both of these guys know each other so well, they don't want to fight each other. I think Tyson Kidd and Sami Zayn just want to go their own ways, but I think they secretly want to know who's the best out of each other. I think I don't know if there's bad blood. Maybe it's just a little bad blood from that attack last week. But I think it's just a mutual thing about going their own ways. Maybe this is just a stepping stone, probably. Let's just see who's the better of the two. But if evident of these past few weeks, it seems Sami Zayn just has a little itch over Tyson Kidd. But nevertheless, Tyson Kidd now working over Sami Zayn. Sami, oh, with a neck breaker. Gets taken down by Tyson. Both these guys, phenomenal. Phenomenal wrestlers, phenomenal talents in that ring. DDT there by Sami. And SmackDown is lucky to have these two. Sami Zayn, of course. Oh, the internet darling that is Sami Zayn. And of course, oh, look at this. Tyson. Oh, go for a... Oh, pump handle slam. But like I said, these guys know each other so well that they know the counters to their own respective moves. And Tyson Kidd, of course, the last official graduate of the Hart Family Dungeon. There's that lifting reverse DDT. Saving grace. And Sami Zayn's going to take the attack to Tyson Kidd. And Tyson Kidd, I mean, just the likes of what he's been trained to. Of course, Bret Hart, along with Natalya and stuff like that. He's been trained by the best of Canada. And, oh, what a drop kick. So, two phenomenal talents here on SmackDown and could go far. So, I think Sami Zayn is probably a future main eventer. Tyson Kidd could get there if he gets the wins under his belt. But Sami Zayn, no, we all know he has the heart and determination of a main eventer, has a star. So, we could see him maybe at the end of the year or early next year fighting for that WWE Championship. Imagine Sami Zayn versus Daniel Bryan for that championship. That would be amazing, but nevertheless, Sami Zayn going to the top rope. No! Tyson Kidd catches him and just throws him right in the middle of the ring. Now going to go for an arm bar, working over the arm of Sami Zayn. Now, oh, seems he wants to let go of the hold. And now Sami, oh, looking for something with Tyson. Well, both these guys are just reversing everything here. I mean, no surprise there. And Sami Zayn. Oh, no. Tyson Kidd with a snapmare. Go for some. No! More reversals. Both of these guys can't get in any offense because the other guy just keeps reversing. And that's what tag team wrestling is all about. Getting to know your opponent, or getting to know your partner, excuse me. Getting to know their moves and how to reverse them. You see it so many times during their matches together, so you I guess, naturally develop a memory about that type of move and how to reverse it. So very well even matchup here right now. Sami Zayn now gonna go for maybe a snap suplex. Yes, he does, and plants Tyson Kidd right to the mat. Gonna go for a cover. 1, 2, and that's not gonna end the match just yet. Tyson, oh, gets caught with a knee right in the back. Now Sami, now gonna pick him up. Gonna turn him over. Now Sammy's, oh man, dragon suplex by Sami Zayn, and now he's rolling. And Tyson Kidd's rolling out of the ring. That's what he's doing. Now he gets back inside the ring. Kind of maybe trying to fake out Sami Zayn. I guess it worked a little bit. Now you gonna drag him over. Now, oh, Tyson. Gonna throw him outside the ring. And Tyson might be going. Oh, here we go. Off the ropes. We're gonna see a plancha. No! Oh! Sami Zayn with a punch right to the face. And it holds true. You know your tag team partner better than they know themselves. Oh, wait a minute. Sami Zayn. Oh! And now Sami Zayn gonna return the favor. Sami Zayn throws him out. Off the ropes. Sami Zayn with a plancha. Top rope plancha. And that takes down Tyson Kidd. Now, oh, right into the barricade. But, oh, and now an elbow right to the face. Sami Zayn. We haven't seen that in a while from Sami or Tyson Kidd, for that matter. But they're pulling on all the stops here tonight against their respective ex-tag team partner. And now look at this. Tyson going for suplex. No. Oh, man, a suplex on the cement. And part of the steel as well. That's not fun for either man. But now a count of five, and Sami Zayn gonna go back to the ring. Tyson Kidd gonna follow him. And now Tyson, oh, they've been looking for that fisherman neck breaker there. Spinning fisherman. And now Sami Zayn gonna go for a Northern Light suplex. Keeps the bridge. 1, 2, and no. Tyson Kidd very close to getting count down with that three count, but gets the shoulder up, and now, oh, forearm right to the face. Sami, now looking for something, but didn't happen. No. Oh. Again, back and forth between these guys. Gonna go for a backbreaker. No. Back flipped out of it. Now knee right to the face. Nothing pretty about that. Just effective. Now Tyson gonna throw Sami Zayn into the turnbuckle. Now, oh, look at these kicks. Oh! X-Pac style. With a rolling kick right to the face. Then look at this. Oh, guillotine leg drop on the bottom rope. Tyson Kidd taking it to Sami Zayn. Now, oh, right to the back. Tyson looking good right now. And now, oh, look at this. Oh, what a neckbreaker. Not quite the fisherman, but he just a snap style neckbreaker from the suplex hold. And now Tyson Kidd. Oh, not a good idea by Tyson Kidd. Sami Zayn was getting up while he was going to the top rope. Now Sami Zayn going to take advantage. Never mind. Tyson Kidd reverses that into an Irish whip. Now look at this. Oh, Sami. Oh, the sunset flip. Could this be it for Tyson? One, two, and no. Versus. Oh, one, two, and another reversal. One, two, and oh. That was close once again. What a match between these two X-Tag Team partners. Showing what. Oh, go for the Haluma kick, but Tyson Kidd again saw it coming a mile away and reverses it. And now Sami Zayn gonna go for a headlock, trying to slow the pace down. And these two guys showcasing not only to the SmackDown universe, not only to Stone Cold Steve Austin, but to you guys at home, what these guys are capable of and why they should be in singles action and why they should be champions here in our universe mode. But now Tyson Kidd gets back to his feet. Snapmare. And they're going to return the favor as he goes for a headlock. But Sami Zayn not down for long as he's getting back to his feet. Oh, elbow. Two elbows and Tyson Kidd backs off. And now into the turnbuckle. Now Tyson might be in some big trouble here. Sami Zayn now sitting him up on the top turnbuckle. What is this? Sami Zayn! Oh, got him up for a superplex. Oh, whoa! Brainbuster, now Lion Salt! Brainbuster into the Lion Salt. I thought he was going to go for a pin there. Maybe he should have. I think Tyson Kidd doesn't know where he is. We haven't seen the top rope brainbuster for a long time from Sami Zayn. So Sami Zayn almost breaking the neck of Tyson Kidd onto the turnbuckle. And now Sami puts him back into the turnbuckle. No. Stiff elbow there by Tyson. Now you go back into the turnbuckle. Again, reversal after reversal from these guys. And now a backbreaker by Sami. Now gonna go for a quick pin. Here we go. One, two, no. Excuse me. And now Sami trying to figure out what does he have to do. He tried the Aluva kick. He might want to try it again. He didn't hit it. So he might want to try that once more. Now look at this. Oh, doing the same mistake as Tyson did earlier. Tyson Kidd was getting back to his feet and Sami Zayn. Oh, gets caught now with an enziguri and falls to the outside. And now this match has spilled to the outside right in front of me in my announce table. Now, oh, DDT on the outside. And now Tyson Kidd. Look over. Oh, jawbreaker by Sami. And now, oh. Sami's aim. Oh, with a big boot right to the side of the head. Almost the Aluva kick. Not quite. And now Sami picks him up. Oh, are we going to see the Blue Thunder Bomb? Yes, we are. Blue Thunder Bomb. One, two, three. That's it. Tyson Kidd just has nothing left. And a win by Sami Zayn. Very nice win by Sami Zayn. And, you know, that's one more loss for Tyson Kidd. Even after such a phenomenal matchup. But Sami Zayn is your victor here tonight. Let's look back of how he won this match. He picks him up and plants him down with a Blue Thunder Bomb. And just after everything that Tyson Kidd has dealt with in this match, he just could not answer the three count. And there is your victor. Sami Zayn is, for right now, the better of the two of InZayn Force. And guys, remember, this is the last official episode of WWE 2K16. Next episode on Raw is WWE 2K17. So hit that subscribe button, and 2K17 will come soon. Guys, we are back here on SmackDown. Christian coming out to the ring. We were supposed to have a scheduled match between Seth Rollins and Ryback, but Seth Rollins was coming down the ring during the commercial break, and Dean Ambrose would attack him from behind, and just, oh, look at these shots. Dean Ambrose just telling Seth Rollins that this is not over, and here it is, the Dirty Deeds on the ramp. So sending a message to Seth Rollins that this rivalry is not over. They have one win apiece, so you gotta think the tiebreaker's coming soon. But right now, we're here with our main event of the evening. Christian coming down to the ring for what should be a phenomenal matchup. Christian now gonna face the returning Cody Rhodes in his return to action here on SmackDown. And here he comes, the familiar music from the former WWE champion in our universe mode, Cody Rhodes, coming down to the ring. And we can officially say now that Cody Rhodes will now face Daniel Bryan in the one of the main events of Battleground for that WWE championship. Daniel Bryan and Cody Rhodes 3 coming to Battleground. What a match that's going to be. Cody Rhodes gets his rematch from Backlash. But Cody Rhodes now has to face Christian here tonight. How will he fare? Is there any ring rust? We will find out right here and right now. Now here we go. Christian, Cody Rhodes, main event of SmackDown. Here we go. Now Christian, go. Oh, look at this. Christian now taking Cody Rhodes to the turnbuckle with a collar and elbow. And Cody Rhodes, oh, with a cheap shot. And Cody Rhodes under this new persona here of the Phoenix. I mean, last week he said he rised up. He needed a little time for himself. And, you know, he's back. He rose from the ashes. And he's a bigger, better, you know, badder than before. And he wants that WWE Championship from Daniel Bryan. But now Cody Rhodes. Now is to see if he loses to Christian here tonight, will he even be ready for Battleground in that WWE Championship match? We never know. But I think he has to get a win here tonight to not only prove to himself, not only prove to Daniel Bryan, but prove to the people that the match, the main event of SmackDown is worth watching. And now, back suplex by Christian. Daniel Bryan, our WWE Champion. Most of our talent, some of our talent is not here tonight on our overseas tour in London. Of course, Finn Balor, Roman Reigns, Tyler Breeze, Randy Orton, Edge, Daniel Bryan, all over there in that London, in that overseas tour. So if this match, or if this episode seems a little short, that's why. In kayfabe reasons, don't worry about it. And just, you know, I wanted a quick episode. So we can get to W2K17 early. Not early, but in relative quick fashion. Now look at this combo by Christian. Christian now working over to Cody Rhodes now just taking Christian to the cement there. I mean, there's obviously no padding, so every move that's hit there is 10 times worse than it would be in the ring or even on the mat. And now Cody Rhodes and Christian getting back inside the ring. I don't think either man want a count of victory. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, man, what a counter. It seemed Christian was going for that flapjack, but Cody Rhodes reverses it into a bolt like never seen that before. And a nice reversal. So for right now, it does not seem like Cody Rhodes has any ring rust. But Christian, now look at this, size him up for a shot right to the midsection. Of course, Christian and Edge have a future tag team title shot coming, presumably at Battleground against the Wyatt family. Of course, the Wyatt family always looming, always searching for their next victim in SmackDown. But, and now Cody Rhodes just working over Christian here. Gonna go for a pin here. Let's go. One, two. No, not even a two count. Christian kicks out. You know, Christian, look at this. Oh, Cody Rhodes with that meaner demeanor about him. Meaner demeanor. he looks different. I mean, he looks, oh, wait a minute. This is similar. Beautiful disaster kick. Beautiful disaster. As now goes for a pin. One, two, and no. Cody Rhodes, I mean, before he, you know, had a hiatus in his career following Backlash, he seemed cheery, he seemed joyful. I mean, he was still having his problems with Daniel Bryan. Oh, wait a minute! That was the crossroads! Forget me talking! Christian might be out! One, two, three, that's it! Wow! Cody Rhodes, a victory here tonight, a very decisive victory against Christian. Christian just could not answer that crossroads. And Cody Rhodes gets an important victory here tonight. Very nice by Cody Rhodes. Well, guys, that'll do it for SmackDown here. No. I jinxed it. The Wyatt family are here. And, oh, man, whoa. Luke Harper and Eric Rowan. Oh, they have chairs. And they're going right after Christian. Cody Rhodes hightailing it out of here. Now, look at these. Look at this attack. These guys are just hammering shots onto Christian with these chairs. Oh, man. Just the calculated shots by Luke Harper and Eric Rowan. And now, look at this. Picks him up from Michinoku Driver and Bray Wyatt. Now, look at this. Oh, you can hear more chair shots in there here. Oh, man. Oh, here we go. The exclamation mark. We've seen this time and time again. We will see it one more time. Bray Wyatt has Christian in his crosshairs for the Sister Abigail. So the Bray Wyatt and his Wyatt family are here tonight. And they send a message to Christian. But not only to Christian, but to Edge and Randy Orton. Oh, man, who can stop the Wyatt family? Well, guys, that'll do it for SmackDown. I will see you on Raw, and more importantly, I'll see you on WWE 2K17. Take care, fellow assassins.